at that time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will start to talk to the first people he talked. Before all that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to Adam alayhi salam. The first one Allah will speak to when he comes to the land of al-Mahshar, Adam alayhi salam, our father, Adam alayhi salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask him, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أخرج بعث النار من أمتي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell Adam alayhi salam, from your ummah that you see, those human beings you see in front of you, all these ummah, choose or pick the people who will be in the hellfire. The people who will be in the hellfire. يقول آدم عليه السلام وما بعث النار فيقول الله جل وعلا من كل ألف 999. So آدم عليه السلام will say how many? How do I know? So Allah سبحانه وتعالى will say out of every 1,999 for the hellfire. لا إله إلا الله. Out of every 1,999 for the hellfire. This is the bad. Alright? So that is the first one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will talk to on the day of judgment when he comes to the land of resurrection. So when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that out of 1,999 in the hellfire, it was difficult on the Sahaba. It was difficult. What is the chance then? Is that a 1% chance? That's 1/10 chance. So it was difficult on the Sahaba. So they asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what's going to happen to us? What is the chance that we're not one of the 999? فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم that every 1,000 from يأجوج ومأجوج for every one of you. That really meaning that the people of يأجوج and مأجوج, Gog and Magog, as we spoke about before, those are Allah, and those are some of the, a lot of the people will be thrown in the hellfire. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ إِنِّي لَأَرْجُ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلْ أَن تَكُونُ رُبَعَ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. Then he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that is his mercy, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. His mercy and his concern about his ummah. His concern about his ummah even on that day. And when we talked about shafa'ah last time, it was a clear proof how much he is concerned sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about his ummah. So he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is an addition from him. This is addition information from him, because they asked him about one thing and now he's adding sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ. He swears by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I wish from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you will be 1/4 of the people in Jannah. فَكَبَّرَ الصَّحَابَ. So the Sahaba went, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. ربع أهل الجنة. Then he said صلى الله عليه وسلم والذي نفس محمد بيده إني لأرجو أن تكون ثلث أهل الجنة. Then he said صلى الله عليه وسلم by Allah I wish from Allah that you will be 1/3 of the people of the Jannah. فكبر الصحابة. 1/3 is bigger than 1/3. Then he said صلى الله عليه وسلم والذي نفس محمد بيده إني لأرجو من الله عز وجل أن تكونوا نصف أهل الجنة. He swears by Allah and he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are half of the people of paradise. And his answer will be, his dua is answered عليه الصلاة والسلام إن شاء الله. That the Muslims will occupy half of the Jannah. or they will be half of the people who are inhabiting or inhabiting the Jannah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after Adam, He calls on Nuh. And the honor for this ummah doesn't stop. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned in the hadith that you are the end, the last ummah of 70 ummah. There are 70 ummah. Mufuna 70 ummah. You are the last. And yet, of 70. And yet, we are one half of paradise. One half of the people in Jannah from this ummah. And all that is honor for this ummah. أنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. So honor from Allah to this ummah doesn't stop even there. He honored their prophet, the prophet of this ummah, by giving him الشفاعة العظمى, and by giving him الشفاعة of opening the door of Jannah, and by giving him الشفاعة to take people out of the hellfire. He continues to honor this ummah with all these things. So what comes after as an honor for this ummah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will talk to Nuh. And he will say, Ya Nuh, قد بلغت. Nuh, did you fulfill the message? Did you deliver? And Allah knows. So Nuh alayhi salam will say yes. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the people of Nuh, قوم Nuh, those people who were drowned. As the hadith said, that 70 people believed in Nuh. 70 people. You know how many years he made da'wah? 950 years. 70, the maximum reports that 70 people believed in him. So Allah will ask them, the people of Nuh, those who were drowned, who rejected him, did Nuh deliver? Did Nuh deliver the message to you? They will say, we don't even know him. He didn't deliver to us. We didn't hear from him. We don't know him. That's what they will say. As I said, think they're smart. They think they can get away. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked Nuh, you say you deliver. Who can testify for you? Who will testify for Nuh alayhi salam? If his whole ummah denied, his people denied, 950 years of work they denied. He says, alayhi salam, Muhammadun wa ummatun. He will say, Muhammad and his ummah. Did we see Nuh? I never seen Nuh. Did anyone here see Nuh? Need to talk to me outside. No one saw Nuh of us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't live at the time of Nuh. Did he see Nuh? He did see Nuh, alayhi salam. Didn't he lead them in Masjid al-Aqsa in the night of Al-Isra? And he saw him in heaven. He saw Nuh. But we didn't see Nuh. And the Prophet ﷺ didn't see Nuh making da'wah to his people. And he wasn't living at the time of Nuh. So how come Muhammad ﷺ and us will testify for that Nuh delivered? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask us, did you see him? Did you hear him? You testify. How you know? They said, because your messenger told us. Because Muhammad ﷺ told us. What Muhammad ﷺ tells us is a fact. It's not open for any kind of doubt. If the hadith is sahih, and it's authentic, and it came from the Prophet ﷺ, it's a fact. وَمَا يَنطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى. It's a fact. You rejected, you're in danger. So imagine those who reject the whole sunnah. They have missed, or they have missed Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is the dalil from the book of Allah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ عَلَيْكُمْ شَهِيدًا. So the ummah of Muhammad will testify for Nuh that he delivered the message, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will testify for his ummah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that in Surah Al-Baqarah. And this is how we made your nation balanced one. Ummah in the middle. لتكونوا شهداء على الناس.